All right, we are at the 100,000 mile range update. Gosh, I never thought this day would come. It is 33 degrees Fahrenheit outside. We got Mr. Laffy Taffy celebrating over here. Celebrating what? I don't know, because now I can't get that daughterboard free replacement from Tesla for the MCU. Oh, well. Charging complete. We have 251 rated miles. We added 137. Charging has been really slow because the Oak Creek supercharger was completely full just a few minutes ago. But I've been fighting other cars for charge rate. No, you're not taking all my gloves out. All right, let's look at TM Spy here. Car thinks pack capacity is 72.9 kilowatt hours, and it thinks it charged to 73.1, which is somewhat amazing because this is probably the highest I've seen in quite a while. Lifetime discharge, 46.182 megawatts, with a lifetime charge of 50.107 megawatts. Vinny, please don't hit my arm. Balance of the pack is 11 millivolts. I got the heat on yet. That's why it's bleeding off. I was going to say voltages are dropping. Let me shut the heat off and see what it goes. Might come back up a little bit. It did think we charged to 100%. I hope so, since we're a little bit above what I thought our pack capacity was. Temperature of the pack is 88.4 degrees of a high and 86.0 as a low. At peak, we were at about 90. Just did not want to warm up today. Okay, Mr. Vincent, thank you. But hey, can you put that? Those things are dangerous. Put those things away. You got sharp, pointy toes. All right, let's look at scanning my Tesla. Get some information at 100,000 miles here. What am I looking for? DC lifetime charge total. I've DC fast charged 36.059 megawatts. AC charged 8.037 megawatts, which brings a charge total to 50.107, 46.182 for lifetime discharge. We already covered that. Regen total, which is kind of awesome. 6.010 megawatts. Yes, over six megawatts of regeneration in 100,000 miles. That's not chump change. Dollar signs there. Dollar signs, folks. Lifetime. Okay, now you just kicked my glasses off. I got toe prints on my glasses. And you, of course, you only do this once I start recording. Lifetime charge cycles, 687. Lifetime discharge cycle, where is it? Discharge cycles. 633 discharge cycles, 687 charge cycles. That shows you, see the difference between that? That's all wasted vampire power that had never gotten to get used. That is a lot of loss. Unacceptably a lot. Vinny! Right now, it will say my BMS max charge rate is 10.7 kilowatt. That's what I would get as regeneration. Yeah, I'm going to try and force start my charging again. Otherwise, I'm going to start getting charged idle fees. You do that by disconnecting, reconnecting. Tesla actually, and newer firmwares will not let you do this. Besides the fact that the user interface is so much better and there is no charge gate scandal, drastically reducing charge rates, and for the interest of keeping, more of a stable baseline here, I'm still on firmware 8.1. You can see the exact flavor there, which will probably be getting an update soon, because I would like my app access back to preheat the car, but I'm also planning on getting MCU2. Okay, let's see. Any other information here? Not really. Sullen balance is getting better. charging started back up. No, it jumped up to 4 kilowatt. And that is it. Probably going to be doing a test next week. I will do one day, I'll do a charge and record the whole charge, or at least probably to 90% maybe, from 0 to 90 on the supercharger. And then I will run all the software updates according to the service center, because I'm still on 8.1. I got about 4, maybe 5 incremental software firmware updates to do to the car. And then I will go right back and see what my charge rates are going up 2.5 years worth of software updates. Adios!